Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science Rockstar Edition. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. I've been having profound ideas about what a society needs to function. We need food to eat and energy for our homes and cars. At some point, we need healthcare. Of course, our society needs infrastructure, like roads and electric lines, transportation like cars, trains, and planes. And where would we be without our consumer goods? TVs, computers, vacuum cleaners, you name it. In this episode of Behind the Science, what would happen if I just snapped my fingers and all of these things just disappeared? Chris.
Hi, Jim, what's wrong?
So I think I did something really terrible. I think I made society disappear.
How could you have done that?
So I snapped my fingers and everything as we know it, our infrastructure, our healthcare, our food, everything just disappeared.
Oh, those are pretty important, but I don't think you made them disappear. They've been around for ages. They've been around since the Han Chinese and the Roman Empire. We're still here. The parking lot's still here. So I think we're still okay.
All of those things have something in common though, right? They're all chemical materials.
They are.
And you do some of that testing,
I do.
Right? Could you show me a little bit more about the importance of this?
Yeah, I can. Let's go in and take a look.
Great. So this isn't a lab.
You're right. Very astute, Jen. So we actually live in a material world. And so out here, there's so many examples to show you. But first, I think what we should do is go to the whiteboard.
Sounds good.
Okay. The world needs to eat. And, you know, if you go back, you talked about society and all the building blocks of society disappearing. You know, if you go back to the Han Chinese and the Roman Empire, there were about 300 or 400 million people. Now there's about 7 or 8 billion people. So there's a lot more people that need to eat. So how do you feed everybody? Well, one way to do that is to make agrochemicals and to increase crop yields. There's an area with product performance and safety with agrochemicals that's important. And one area that we looked at recently was triazole fungicides. And there's a little blue star next to these molecules. And what that means is that they have an enantiomer center. And this is basically a way for us to make sure that what we put on the crops is going to be more biologically useful. And then also we can actually separate out the stuff that's not biologically useful. And then that won't get into the streams and get into our water supply.
It sounds like here at Waters, we make a lot of instrumentation and technologies that are very useful in helping to test the safety and efficiency of some of these agrochemicals.
You got it, Jen. And it's not just agrochemicals and food. It's also the materials that are in our society that you talked about at the beginning. In our parking lot, in the cars, there's polymers. There was polymers in the airplane that just flew up above. They're in our cell phone. And that's the example I want to show you next. And let's go to the whiteboard and talk about that.
Great, let's take a look.
All right. So Jim, as you can see from this diagram here of a Boeing 787, about 50% of the airplane is comprised of metal, as you probably would expect, but another 50% is advanced composites, and those advanced composites are made of polymers and all kinds of different things, and it's quite similar to the cars in the parking lot. One thing that we were able to do with our technology is look at the polymers from both a physical perspective, to look at its toughness or things like that, and then also to look at it from a molecular perspective.
Material science is nothing new, but it is constantly evolving to meet societal demands. With those demands is the requirement for better analytical methods to develop these materials, or more importantly, use the technology to develop safer products. And as Madonna would say, but I hope to see much clearer after living in the material world. Check out the link below for more details on what you learned today and applications specific to living in the material world. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science Rockstar.